So this is the experimental setup for finding the critical speed of the given shaft. You will be provided with three different shafts. One is made of copper, another one is steel of smaller diameter, and another one is steel of bigger diameter, which is already being fixed. These two ends are fixed, and the length of the shaft is 1 meter. We have to measure it, and there is a motor which is for rotation, for providing the rotational motion of the shaft. And we finding the critical speed of the shaft, you have to provide the rotary motion to it. The shaft will start rotating. You have to observe, keep on increasing the speed of the shaft, so that at one particular point, when you keep on increasing the speed, at one particular point you will get an elliptical shape. So you have to carefully find out that, and that at that time you have to take the tachometer, and you have to find the speed by directing the tachometer onto the shaft. You will directly get the reading, the speed of the shaft in the tachometer. So this is the experimental value, and in the theoretical value, you have to substitute all the values which we have explained and compare these two values. So in this way, we are finding the critical speed of the given shaft. So now we do the experiment. So it is being switched on, and there is a control switch that is being provided, which is used to control the speed. There is a knob for increasing and decreasing the speed. So you have to slowly provide the it is like a regulator. It is a regulator. Slowly provide the speed. So once you have to slowly increase the speed, if you see, the elliptical part will be coming. You have to gradually increase. So at this stage, you see this elliptical part, which you have seen it in the diagram. So you have to measure the speed by, this is a tachometer. So from that, you can directly measure the value of the rotational speed. That is the, this is the critical speed, and you can take the measurement directly. This is coming as 290. Sorry. We'll check, we should come as constant value, keep on changing. Yes, 491. So as in the previous case, we are going to conduct the experiment for the other two given shafts. One is for steel, which is a smaller diameter, and the other one is a copper shaft. You have to do the same, you have to repeat the same procedure for this also. So we are having another experiment, which is the determination of whirling speed of shaft. So what is whirling speed is? It is the critical speed of the shaft, in which the shaft tends to vibrate transversely, and this will cause the center of gravity eccentrically move away from the axis of rotation of the shaft. So this whirling, we are going to find out that critical speed. So in this experiment, we are going to determine the speed for various diameter shafts. The shaft diameter is varied, and the material is also varied, and we are going to find out the critical speed, and we are going to do find out the theoretical values also, and compare the experimental and theoretical values. So what the apparatus required is a shaft, the tachometer for measuring the speed of the shaft, and for chakki, and the regulator is also, the AC voltage regulator is used to regulate the speed of the shaft. And in this experimental setup, so there will be two ends. These ends are fixed, and the shaft is being fixed in between these two ends, and with the help of the voltage regulator, we are providing a rotary motion to the shaft. So there will be a formation of geometry like this. If this geometry comes beyond that, if you give a rotational speed to this shaft, it will fail. So this is what is called as critical speed, right? And the various things, before going into that, we use some formulas for this. We are going to find out the critical speed, right? So theoretical whirling speed is given by 0.4985 multiplied by deflection divided by 1.27 into 60 in RPM. So this deflection is a UDL deflection. So that is the formula. 5 W L power 4 divided by 384 EI. W is the weight of the shaft per meter. weight of the shaft per meter. So m into g divided by l. Here the l value is 1 meter. The shaft length is meter. We are not going to change the length. And l is the distance between the supports. E is the Young's modulus of the material in Newton per meter square. And I is the mass moment of inertia of the shaft, which is given by pi by 64 into d power 4 meter power 4. The values which are being provided to you will be Young's modulus of the material. We are going to measure the burning speed of three different shafts. One is a steel, another one is also steel having different diameter, and last one is copper. So the material Young's modulus for steel is being given, and copper is also being given to you. And we have to find the distance between the supports. You have to measure it, which is L is equal to 1 meter. And in the tabulation, it is being shown steel, and the mass of the steel shaft is being provided to you, 0.584, and D is the diameter of the shaft, and length of the shaft is 1 meter. We are going to find the mass moment of inertia by applying the formula pi by 64 into d power 4, where d is the diameter. We are going to substitute the value. W, weight of the shaft is given by m into g divided by l. So m value will vary for the three different shafts, and we are going to find the weight. And experimentally we are going to find the whirling speed, and theoretically we are going to find the whirling speed. Theoretically we have to use the formula, and for experimental values you have to give a rotational speed to the shaft, and it will start rotating, and you have to see whether it's an elliptical shape. You have to just check where the elliptical shape is coming. At that point you have to use your tachometer to find the speed that will give you the critical speed, beyond which if the speed is being given to that shaft, there will be failure. It will start vibrating violently. So we'll see the experiment.